runs in the garage in front of the open car trunk. I see carnation on the covers of the trunk, like crumpled paper, all things carnation for arms. It hurts to look. I'm out of here, I'm on to church, says Mom, her eyes wide open like a child's eyes. I promised, I said I'd be there. You know you should call me first. I told you your voicemail falls for truth. The translucent spread in the bare left cheek palm. Mom blinks, I know that blink. Please, Mom, I think my voice is quite redundant. Sorry, she says, and looks at her carnations. I promise, I have to go, she says, and I see a moment of tear on her radiant cheek. Blinks. Can you please take my leave with you? I have a clue, I need to rest, I say, step closer. Sorry, she says, stepping back. She falls in the car, shuts the door. A pink carnation slips from her lap and gets smashed in the door jam, sticking out like lace covered in blood. Can I just watch TV? I ask with a half open window. She looks at me, blinks, and yes, sure, forces herself to end in love, then backs out of the garage. Wheels roll. I go inside.
Her next 2 months. Masturbation. Maddie's upper lip quivers. Nothing moves. Just one small. Almost invisible to your face. Mommy. 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 I run out of the car. I snatch her up from the snow. Press her to me. Squeeze her. Her hair is still unwashed. Making me sick. She stops on her side, reasonably, pause. I push my jacket into the red leather and say, Mommy's here, Mommy stays, and shake.